Yeah, you know, I'm so delighted to have witnessed this video on the history of yoga by Deepika Kothari and Ramji Om. I had never imagined that this video would be so fantastic. I've seen lots of videos, seen lots of documentaries, seen a lot of films on yoga's history and so on. But I've never seen something so comprehensive, something which is so far-reaching, sweeping, deeply researched, extremely well-produced. So, you know, this is a very educational film. It's a film that will tell us about our history from the Indus civilization on to today. It will tell about yoga, which I think is the signature quality of Indian civilization, which has been captured very nicely. It will take us to all corners of the country and show us how it has been part of the tradition everywhere. And all the different traditions, Buddhism, Jainism, Hinduism, different traditions, Shaivism, Vaishnavism, Goddess, all of that is brought together as part of this grand history of our people from Indus Valley, physical infrastructure of the Indus Valley, and yoga as sort of the spiritual and psychological infrastructure. The inner infrastructure of yoga is combined with the outer infrastructure of Harappan Indus Saraswati civilization in a very beautiful way. Because typically the archaeologists only talk about the outer, and some so-called religious people will talk about the inner. But you can't have history with only the inner. You can talk about philosophy. You can have a book or a video on philosophy that is not connected with physical things. But when you connect the philosophy of yoga and the practice with the physical structures, their structures have history, then you also get into the history of yoga. So I think this is a remarkable contribution. I congratulate the producers, the people who put in many, many years of tapas. They've really worked hard, I can tell from this video. Having traveled around India, having done my own work there, I know that this kind of very intense, very rigorous, very detailed research, and then turning it into very, very short, quick clips, you know, to get it all compactly, is a monumental work. And I wish them well. I mean, we are on the same journey. I think that the producers are doing what I want people to do, rather than sort of talking about it or complaining. They've actually gone out and done something. This can be turned into education. It should be shown in film festivals. It should be given awards. It should be something that the various state governments and central government should adopt as part of teaching them who we are. It should be presented in intellectual conferences. And I think it will help counteract a lot of the propaganda, false propaganda that yoga is somehow imported from the West. Unfortunately, those kind of things are getting a lot of publicity. They are being given a lot of grants to go around traveling, talking, publicizing, and they're given a lot of academic credentials because of who they are, because of their clout and so on. Whereas I think this is far more authentic and much more persuasive and a much higher quality of rigor that went into this. So I'm very happy that I was asked to come in, you know, in the launch ceremony to inaugurate this DVD on the history of yoga, which we did on January 26, Republic Day, in Mumbai. And another reason this day was very special is because BKS Iyengar got India's highest award, which is the Padma Vibhushan. And I think he's sort of the representative of yoga today. And your video, as the best video I have seen, best film I have seen on this subject, coming together on the same day and being asked to honor it as the chief guest and give my talk, was absolutely fantastic.
मंतव्यो निदिध्यासितव्यः उसको अध्यास लगना चाहिए।